near environment of Venus. Author Russell Smith. The photographs herein are part of a 5-year documentary. This particular segment commences February 20th, 1980. Scene condition was good. Film ED 200, 135, 36 exposure. Utilizing the Petri FTE, ERT with an F15 refractor. 7 to 6.2 millimeter aperture by 1200 millimeter focal length. And studying the near environment of Venus, the object of this investigative session is to determine the rotational period of Venus from 2/20/1980 to 5/6/1980. And beginning this segment, utilizing a wide field view of Venus showing its satellites. The total number of satellites discovered to date by the author since 1975 have numbered 6. The satellites of Jupiter of Venus is frame number 1, date 2/20/1980, Venus at 6 minutes of arc diameter, at 6:56 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, a 4-minute exposure. Frame number 2, Venus at 0.5 minutes of arc diameter, taking at 7:12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 4-minute exposure. These photographs of Venus showing the surface topography is the minimum angular diameter that can be used in the corner. Planetary surfaces within our solar system. Frame number 3, Venus at 0.5 minutes of arc diameter, 7:16 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6-minute exposure, 2/20/1980. It's clear and cold. Scene conditions are good. Atmosphere is stable. Center features of interest is the round crater-like feature near the top of the sphere of Venus. I'm looking down into an apparent darker area on Venus that have been has been noted to be tilted 63 degrees to the vertical of its orbital plane. That means that the North Pole is facing Venus on eastern elongation, and the South Pole is facing Venus on western elongation, with approximately 25 degrees in the equatorial region, dark region on the western hemisphere. Shadows in the eastern hemisphere, 25 degrees on the equator in the light ocean. So arc diameter, taking at 7:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 4-minute exposure. since the last session on 2/20/1980. As we can see, appear to be more differential features on Venus. Frame number 9. And 10. Venus at 3.8 meters of arc diameter, taken at 735 and 739 4-minute exposure. Venus at 6 minutes of arc diameter, taken at 750, 3-minute exposure. These are Venus taken on 3/4/1980 at 6 minutes of arc diameter from 637. This frame number 16, taken on 3/4/1980. Frame number 15 at 7:15, a 5-minute exposure at 6 minutes of arc diameter. Showing the relative position of the satellites. In this frame, one of the largest satellites of Venus can be seen. In the next frame number 16, Venus at 6 minutes of arc diameter, taken at 7:19 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, a 3-minute exposure. This was a second quadrant composition relative to the crosshairs in my field of finest eyepiece in the macro episode. Frame number 16 was utilized for satellite measurements. Since Venus being off-center would give wider dispersion of the satellite's position for better view and composition. At this time, the brightest one near Venus, Aquarius, was utilized to as the center object in my field of view in the crosshairs. Frame number 17, Venus at 0.5 meters of arc diameter, taken at 8:49 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, a 5-minute exposure. So 3/4/1980. Here we can see that bottom of the screen, Venus appears to be eclipsed, a shadow eclipse. Partial eclipse has occurred. The terminator is to the right of the screen. The north pole is to the upper left of the screen. You can see the apparent circular feature, that is the true north pole of Venus, tilted 63 degrees. At 6 minutes of arc diameter, taken at 10:25 and 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on 3/4/1980, 5 minutes and a 9-minute exposure. Frame depicts the ring system of Jupiter and also the Galilean satellites, which are grounded in the high orbital of Jupiter on this exposure. Jupiter's binary is 6 minutes of arc diameter, 10:30. I was able to visualize and also photograph the Galilean satellites in this particular photograph, which is difficult to show up on the copy. The video copy of the 35mm transparency. This is Mare Crisium, the lunar limb, at 6 minutes of arc diameter from 1050 to 1053, utilizing 25 second exposures. just to show a relative phase of the Earth's moon and the apparent diameter of my field of view at 6 minutes of arc diameter. Frame number 29 is Venus at 6 minutes of arc diameter, typically 7:03 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 minutes exposure, date 3/5/1980. The following are all taken on 3/5/1980. Frames number 24 through frames number 29. Satellites of Venus, they are at elongation, showing the maximum distance of the outer satellite with reference to Venus. To get a true picture of Venus, we would have to refer back to an earlier frame when a very short exposure of Venus was given at this angle in order to delineate its true angle of size. In time exposures, it is difficult to maintain the same linear diameter of the parent body due to the high albedo of Venus, which causes an extended overexposed view. However, even in the extended overexposures, Venus, the error in tracking is a plus or minus 10% of the radius of the subtended angle. This frame number 25 is Venus at 0.5 minutes of arc diameter, September 7, 15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 minute exposure on 3/5/1980. The purpose of this chronological illustration of the phases of Venus over a period from 220 to 80 to 3 to 5, 6, 1980 on the same roll of film is to note any changes due to weather conditions on Earth. We're not able to get consecutive day-to-day visualization of the rotational period of Venus. Even though in these photographs, Venus is still showing some apparent rotation from east to west, from the top of the screen, which is northeast, bottom, which is northwest. This is frame number 27, taken at 7:27 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 3/5/80, 5 minute exposure. Angular linear diameter of Venus in the sky at the time approximately 25 circles of arc linear diameter. So since my field of view at this angle, 0.5 minutes of arc, is 30 circles of arc diameter, Venus is almost equal to my field of view, approximately 75% of my field of view. Supreme number 20, this was the frame number 27, Venus, at 727. On 3/5/1980, I usually begin with a wide angle view of Venus to delineate the satellites in their relative position if they can be viewed. And try to give the wide angles also a 5 minute exposure. Working with the optical system developed by the author for resolving planetary topography at visual wavelengths, I have been able to decrease the time exposure factor by approximately 9 times, whereas when I be commenced in my astrophotography work, it was taken approximately 45 minutes to an hour to image a Venus working at a power of 300 diameters, utilizing a camera at the focus of the ERT system developed by the author, which stands for Astro Reconnaissance 2. Utilizing Model 110 and Model 80 land camera, utilizing 3000 speed film with an F11 for the camera. This photograph of Venus was an attempt to also show the satellite of Venus at the 0.5 minutes of arc diameter, frame number 28 at 7:32 p.m. 6 minute exposure. Frame number 30 is Jupiter, the satellite, full quadrant composition at 3.8 minutes of arc diameter. Time of the exposure, 7:08 p.m. and 9:22 p.m. The 32 was Saturn at 3.8 minutes of arc diameter. 10 minute exposure, 5 center composition. This is frame number 33. Venus at 6 minutes of arc diameter, 7 o'clock p.m. 3 minute exposure, 5/6, date 5/6/1980. Frame number 34, Venus at 3.8 minutes of arc diameter, 7:04 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 minute exposure, 5/6, which is made since 1980. Frame number 35, Venus at 0.5 minutes of arc diameter, taken at 7:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6 minute exposure. We can note quite a contrast in the surface topography of Venus that had changed over a period from 2/20/1980 to 5/6/1980. This is Venus at 0.5 minutes of arc diameter, taking the 720. since my earlier work, 1975, 76, and 77, was primary to delineate the larger satellites of Venus. Due to the short time Venus is above the horizon, it's difficult to ascertain lengthy exposures over a period of hours. The last frame is Venus at 6 minutes of arc diameter, taken at 7:45 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, a 5-minute exposure. Film Chronicle, the best delineating the surface of